फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर वी ऑल? क्या करें, ये बारिश, दिस रेन एंड दीज मैंगोज, राइट? व्हाट टू डू? एंड दिल बेईमान तो है ही है, सो लेट्स डू अनदर बेईमानी टुडे, एंड अगेन इन द सेम फैशन वील अगेन मेक इट मेक दिस डिश वेरी वेरी लाइट. थोड़ा सा If you remember, last time we had made Punjabi Pooda. So this time what we'll do is we'll make Pooda again with a little bit of infusion. And infusion mein hum kya karenge? We'll use, very right, we'll use the mango in infusion now. And for this what we are going to do is, we'll make it again in that healthy and the lighter mode, all right. Lighter version, that is. So what I have done is, very first thing, I took one mango and I took out the pulp from it and I mashed the pulp and I kept the pulp here. Okay, so that's step number one. One mango or one and a half mangoes depending upon the quantity of pulp, and this pulp will be about say around a little more than half a cup. One. Now, once the pulp has been taken, what we will do is, we are going to take a curd, let's say another about little lesser than half a cup. This is fresh curd, homemade curd, and I have combined the curd and the mango together. Okay? Once this has been combined, now this becomes our base and we allow the infusion to take place between the two of them. Okay, so that's step number one. Allow the mango, take the mango pulp, add curd to it, approximately same quantity, and we leave it together for little time, let's say 10-15 minutes together. But here it is separated, we have to mix the two together. Now, as usual, as we had done last time, we are going to again take semolina, right? And semolina we are going to combine it with rice flour, as I had done earlier, because now because of mango and curd, semolina and rice flour is definitely required. Reason is, to bring in crispiness. Otherwise, the pura or the malpua will not become crispy. Okay, so because there's moisture here also, there's a lot of moisture here also. So to bring in the crispiness, we need both of these ingredients. Now, along with this, I wanted to give it a little texture. Otherwise, this will be too, you know, flattish sort of a texture. So for the texture, I have added coconut powder, grated coconut powder. Okay, how we'll do it, I'll also tell you. Now, all these dry ingredients we mix together, right? The semolina, the rice flour in equal quantity, this coconut powder in equal quantity again, and as usual, if you remember, jaggery. So, around with this combination, so you need about is around 30 grams or so, let's say 15 to 30 grams should be more than enough, because as you remember I eat very less sugar, so I take it on the lesser side. So this for me would be around 15 grams or so, but you can take it according to your wish. And like last time again, pink salt. And pink salt again is one and a half pinch, not more than that. Now these are the main ingredients of your recipe so far. Now to give a little bit of flavor, a little bit of fragrance, we are going to add as usual, as last time we had added crushed cardamom seeds, crushed cardamom. And we are going to mix it together with this only. Okay. And Now, if you have a look at this, now when you're going to mix all these ingredients, what is going to happen is that your batter is going to be a little sticky. Okay. Now to make the malpua or the puda, you'll have to cook it a little longer in oil. Now, when you're going to do that, remember your puda is going to get heavy. Now, how do you stop it from getting heavy? And you ensure that there's no digestive problem. It should not go and sit in your stomach. There should be no heaviness. There should be no acidity. There should be no bloating. And you should not feel heavy. It should digest very quickly in the normal run. And you should not feel heavy, because as I had done last time, I'm going to make it again in desi ghee. Okay, because I don't use oil. You can use an olive oil. You can use desi ghee also. You can use white butter. You can use any refined oil that you want. But I prefer desi ghee. I prefer olive oil. I prefer white butter. So that will be my choice. But you can go by your choice also. And to stimulate this digestion part, what I'm going to add is about 15 grams of fennel seeds. Okay, any seed or fennel seed, either of the two. Sonf. Okay, so thoda sa sonf, we'll all add it together. Now again, the technique is the same. The mixing technique is same. Your all these ingredients are to be mixed together. Right? Why I am not mixing today, I'll give you the reason also. So your semolina, your rice flour, your coconut powder, your jaggery, your pinch of salt, your cardamom, and your fennel seed or sonf, they go in together into one. Mango and curd are mixed together. Once this thing is mixed and thoroughly mixed, then this is mixed with them. Okay, so do not interchange this. Mango and curd first are mixed together. They sit for about 5 to 10 minutes by the time you are mixing this. Then mix this with all these, okay, mango and curd with these ingredients, and of course these ingredients have also gone into them, that is fennel seed and cardamom. Now in case you feel your batter is thicker, you have to balance your batter, not with water, with warm milk. Okay, so you have to take warm milk and balance your batter. Now what is going to be the thickness? I'm just going to show you, because now here comes the real reason why I'm not mixing now. Reason is, I have already mixed this for you and I have already kept it in the kitchen, and the longer you keep, the better it is. I hope you got the reason. The reason is here. This is your reason. Mix, make the batter, rest aside in the fridge for, let us say, 1.5 to 2 hours or 3 hours. But I personally will prefer about 8 to 10 hours in the fridge. Okay? Reason? Yes, yes, yes. The sour taste is going to come from this. Okay? That kata taste will allow the fermentation of all these ingredients to take place. That is, all these will ferment. They will all infuse with each other. We'll allow that time to them. And then, after 8 hours, or let us say if you want after 2 hours or 1.5 hours, when you make your malpua or your puda, is not going to be that sweet. It is going to have a very 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 rich mango flavor, and it is going to have that kata flavor because of rice and because of curd. So that balances with the light sugar coming through, that is brown sugar, and the salt to balance all this, and the fennel to aid in your digestion, and cardamom, crushed cardamom, that is, for smell and fragrance. I hope you have followed now. So step 1, mango curd. Step 2, semolina, rice flour, coconut powder, jaggery, little bit of salt, fennel, and cardamom. Mix together. Second step, once these dry ingredients are mixed, please add these here to them. Balance with this, and what should your batter look like? Come, we'll go to the kitchen and I'll show you what your batter should look like, because I have already done it. I kept it for 8 hours and I'm going to show you that. Okay? Well, follow me. Let's go. Come. Well friends, this is the consistency that we want, okay? Your mixture should be flowing like this, or your batter should be flowing like this. Not thick, not very loose, medium, more than the dosa thickness batter, okay? So have a look again and let's fry. Now the oil is hot. And let's pour slowly. Allow the batter to spread all by itself. Okay, don't touch it. Allow it to spread. And see that spot in the center? It is a little thick. So let's pour a little oil on that. Otherwise, when we are going to flip, it can tear from here, and it will take very long to cook. So let's start pouring some oil on it, okay, so that it cooks and it becomes a little more firmer. This is because of the mango in it. It is going to take longer time to cook. So you have to adjust the timing of your frying with the thickness, with the crispiness that you want. If you want it very crispy, then you have to give it more time. If you want it normal, soft and slightly crispy, then you have to give it lesser time. Look at that. That is the effect. You see that mango caramelizing now? The brown sugar and the mango, this is the effect of it. Look, lovely, isn't it? So, almost hardened now. So, let's flip this. Slowly, slowly, and be very careful when you are going to flip it, because it can tear from the middle. So don't allow it to tear. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Beautiful, isn't it? Look at the colors. And look at the edges going crisp. And look at the center. Crisp, isn't it? You want to have it? Well, let it cook. Let's allow it to cook first. Then we're going to definitely have it. Allow it to fry. Allow it to become crispier. Now if you want to make it even more crispier, as I said, then you can flip it again twice, like we had done earlier also, but not really required, because I don't want to have it very very crispy. It is all up to your choice. Look at that, frying well, isn't it looking lovely. Okay, now let's take it off from the flame. It's done. But if you want to make it more crispy, you can still fry it. You can flip it once and then you can flip it again for about 10-15 seconds each side. But this is all that I wanted. There it is. And now let us taste it. Okay, let us taste it now. But I'm going to taste it, right? And let's see. Wonderful. Do you hear the crunch? By any chance, do you hear the crunch? It's good, isn't it? It's really good. So, please do try it, and do not change the ratios of the ingredients that I have shown. Keep the recipe same. Do try it. Do let me know. Do let everybody know, and in the comments as to how you like this mango version of Malpua or Pura, right? The healthy version again. Repeating once again, the healthy version of Malpua or Pura. Okay? So till my next video, it's is bye to all of you all. Have a nice time, and I'm waiting for your comments. Okay.